So how are you doing today? Welcome to Joey K's Art Studio here at Art South. It's a beautiful morning in April. We got here before noon. Nice and cool here. Today we'll be working on our latest project. It's right behind me. This project is being designed for my parents' house. I'm making it big enough so that you can see it from anywhere they put it in the yard. This project was designed specifically to be a modern art take, what my sculpture should look like. So I thought today we would talk a little bit about the philosophy behind the sculpture here. It is resembling a sand dollar in some ways, but yet obviously oversized. The impression of what a sand dollar is and expanding it. Sand dollars, somewhere around 300 million years. Human race 10,000 years. So we get a concept of the shortness of span that humans have taken up, but yet how much we've transformed here and how we need to be more like sand dollars and regenerate ourselves back into the world the way a sand dollar does. And in that way the earth can be less negatively affected by our existence. Well, the nice things about the sculpture is that you're able to see through it. I like that about the sand dollar, and that it had this plant-like shape that adds openness to the internal structure of the sculpture. I also like the sand dollar for its flatness on one side, it's facing you, and then on the other side, it's much more of a thin shape. It doesn't necessarily show the openness. So as you evolve around the sculpture, it opens up to you in a way that a moon goes from a quarter moon to a full moon as the month goes on. I keep on referring to it as a sand dollar, well, because, you know, that's what it closest resembles, but I realize that it's not actually a sand dollar. And that is an important point in the sculpture, is that we're not actually creating a sand dollar. We're just creating something that reminds you of the sand dollar. Another interesting tidbit about the sculpture is that you're able to see through the sculpture. So through the leaf pattern that's on the sculpture, you'll actually view the ever-changing evolvement of plant life behind it. And the sculpture itself is ever-changing. Not only as you tour around the sculpture, but as you look through the sculpture. David Smith, to me, is the one that brought this transformation of sculpture as you tour around it into sculpture itself in the 1940s. Before that, it was more of a constructionist view of sculpture, and that what you see from one side reflects what you see from the other side. And with the modernist view of sculpture, what you see from one side changes as you move to the other side. That gets us to the point where we're about ready to go in there and do some actual working on the sculpture. Yesterday I bought a brand new giant tank of argon CO2 gas. Got some new gloves again. This time they're from Pakistan and they're goatskin welding gloves. So I really look forward to putting those on and getting down to some business here. We got some new stuff coming for you. Hey, you know. So we got a new tool. Right here. All right, so if you can see, there's a dent here. I want to get rid of that dent. That right there. That camera. And, maybe we can see me stick my arm up through here, down this dent out. That's quick. That's what we do with this one. Oh, it don't work once yet. Beat it some more. Thank you. edges are coming out here. I'm going to bend these back so that it fits flush on here. Same goes for this one. Currently, we've hammered this in and we're trying to keep it as tight as possible, this piece of wood up against the edge, so that we can weld it as far out as possible. Catching anything?